Okay, let's see. Hopefully this is better. Okay, so let's see if this is any better. So this one, I'm not going to delete. Okay, good morning, Darice. We're having some technical difficulties, so I hope it's a little bit better now. Better. Okay. Cool. I had to switch my Wi-Fi real quick. So hopefully that's better. So hopefully everybody comes on in to this one. Good morning, Natasha. Good morning, Cousin Kim. Good morning. I'm going to delete this other one so nobody will be confused. Let me go in and delete it really quick. Good morning. Good morning. Okay. Yeah, let me delete this one. Okay. Good morning. Good morning, Tammy. Better. Okay, perfect. Perfect. All right. So hopefully everybody jumps onto this new one. Hopefully everybody jumps on to this new one. Let's see. All right, well, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna get started for the lack of time. It is 5:36. Good morning and welcome. Love the hair. Thanks, girl. You know, every Monday we got something new. So welcome to the Reignited Prayer Call, our Monday prayer call. I am your intercessor this morning, Miss Jackie Morrison. I'm so excited to be on with you today. God is so good. I hope you had a restful, relaxing, joyful weekend this past weekend. Everybody set their clocks back. I see. Then you're on here on time this morning. Amen. So, it's good work because right. I'm telling you, like for real, like people need to hear this one because I know I needed to hear it this morning as well. Vicky, good morning, Vicky. Good morning, Tanisha. She said, yes, we got it going. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started in a word of prayer. Dear God, Lord, we thank you, God, even through this technical difficulty, God. We know that your word is still going to go forth, oh God. Lord, so we thank you in advance for this word this morning, God. We thank you in advance that somebody's going to get something out of this word and apply it to their lives and change their lives, oh God. Lord, I ask right now that you decrease me and increase you, oh God. Lord, bring the word up out of me, oh God, to be delivered to your people, oh God. Lord, we just love you this morning. We thank you this morning, God, and we give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise, oh God. Come into this room on this morning and move on our behalf. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. So, okay, Dana's back over. Shalonda. All right. Awesome. Great, great, great. So this morning, Friday, I took off work and I had to do some stuff with my mom and my stepdad and took them to some doctor's appointments. And I know I needed a new cell phone. I needed a new cell phone and I just been regretting and just like, no, I don't want to go get one. I don't want to go get one. It was working fine, but something was going on with the charger. And it was an iPhone 7. Y'all, I'm team iPhone. I'm sorry, team iPhone. And so I said, I really don't want to order another phone or go get it repaired. I really need to go in and upgrade, because it's been about what, three, four upgrades. I had a seven and we all the way to 11 now. And so I did all my errands and I said, okay, it's time to go get my new phone. Time to go get my new phone. So I went on to Sprint to go get my phone. Good morning, First Lady Vinay, to go get my cell phone from Sprint. And we started doing all the little upgrades, and I just kept stressing to the girl, listen, baby, I need you to make sure that all my stuff comes over on this phone. Like, I can't be one of them people who lose all their contacts or lose all their, emails or their notes. And I mean, because I have everything on this cell phone. So I kept stressing to her how much I needed everything on the phone. And so hold on one second. My mom's asking me, do I need to go back in? Let me just tell her to go back. So anyhow, I had to leave my cell phone with the woman as she transferred everything over because I had so much stuff in my phone. For instance, I had like 10,000 pictures. Your input is invalid. I had like 10,000 pictures in my phone. And so I needed to make sure that every single picture came over, right? And so I had to leave my phone with the girl. And I was already like, I got to leave my phone. I'm not going to have my phone. What am I going to do, right? Because, I mean, you know, nowadays the phone is connected to our hips. And so I said, all right. I said, I'm going to leave my phone with you. Just call my my call me because I still have my watch. I have my Apple Watch, right? And so with my watch, you know, you can still make phone calls. You can still get your text messages and you can do all of those things, right? But I just didn't have that device, you know, in my hand. And so as soon as I got in the car to run another errand while my phone was at the place, I said, ooh, let me put my GPS so I can get here quicker. And I was looking around, I was like, dang, I don't have my phone. I was like, man, I don't have my phone to see my GPS. And so I'm like, okay, now I got to use my brain to remember how to get to my next destination quicker, right? You know, back in the day, we didn't have all this GPS and MapQuest and Waze and all these different things. And so I said, well, I said, somebody said Team Android. Bitsy. And so you know, I used to you knew how to get to different places, but now I MapQuest everything. I don't care if I'm going up the street. I'm like, let me see how I can get here quicker. I MapQuest everything. And so anyhow, so I had to use my brain. So I got to the store, did what I had to do, and I was able to, you know, use my watch. So, you know, if my husband called or whatever, I could still use my watch. So I still had a little bit of, you know, access to my phone, right? And so I went back, got my phone, came home, was excited, started doing my little stuff on my phone, and I noticed it was kind of tripping, you know, like it would freeze up on me, and I was trying to download the different apps I needed, and it was still freezing, and I'm like, man, what's going on with this, you know? So I went to bed. I woke up throughout the night looking at my phone to see if the progress had increased, and it hadn't increased. I woke up the next morning, and it just started going crazy. I was trying to pair my watch to my new phone, and so I had to reset my entire watch. And I'm going somewhere, y'all, so just hold on. I know this is a long story, but just give me a minute. And so I had to reset my watch to the phone, and it wasn't working correctly. So the next morning I was at Sprint at 9 a.m. They open up at 9 o'clock. I was there at 9 o'clock. But the girl that was helping me didn't come in until 1. So I had to come back when she came back. And so anyhow, you know, I came back at 1 and I was telling her, you know, something's going on. My phone is freezing. I don't know what's going on. And she said I needed more memory. I needed some more memory. I didn't have enough. So I had to upgrade to another phone with more gigabytes in order for it to hold all of my stuff. My God. And so anyway, this time, though, I had to leave my phone again, right? But this time, I didn't just have to leave my phone. I had to leave my watch. So I had no access to nothing for 2 hours, okay? And so I left my watch because, you know, I had to reset my watch. So I told the girl, well, you might as well go and pair everything. So that way when I leave this time, you know, everything is already set up for me. Well, for 2 hours, I didn't have my phone. And I felt just naked. I felt like something was missing. I mean, every few minutes I'm looking around like, oh, let me grab my phone and look at this. Oh, I need to go call this person. Oh, I need to add this note on my phone. And I noticed how dependent I was of my cell phone. I was super depending on my cell phone for everything. And I said, man, I can't believe that I'm so dependent on this cell phone. Yeah, Shalonda said, I know you about to die. Girl, you know I did. Oh, my goodness. And so the question I have for you this morning is, what is your crutch? What are you depending on? And are you depending on God as much as you're depending on that crutch? And that crutch can be anything. See, for me, that crutch is my cell phone. That crutch is my cell phone. See, I go to it for everything. Everything's on it. It's my life. I mean, I don't know. You know, it was even hard to go 2 hours without that phone. I even think about my kids, and when I take their phone, they be about to die on the floor crying because I got their cell phone. And I said, now I see why, because I wanted to crawl up on the floor and cry without my phone. And so are we dependent on God like that? Are we really making sure that we're taking everything to him? See, we say we depend on him, but are we really depending on him? And like I said, that crutch can be your cell phone. That crutch can be one of your children. That crutch can be your spouse, your boyfriend. That crutch can be a church member. It can be a pastor. You know, your crutch can be your job, your business. What is your crutch? James said, I'm convicted already. What is your crutch? You know, we there's something that we're leaning on so much that we have to think about it, because we might be leaning on it more than we're leaning and depending on God, right? And so, you know, I thought about, you know, when I got in that car and I was trying to get ready to put that GPS in and go to Sam's Club. And I said, dang, I don't got my GPS. And I thought about it. I said, well, you know what? God needs to be our GPS. And I said, well, GPS, he's the good protective shepherd. God is our GPS. When I'm confused and I'm trying to get to my next destination, or I'm trying to get there, I should be looking at God. God should be the one to get me to where I need to go. I should be leaning and depending on him. I don't need to lean and depend on this crutch, and not just for the big things, but for the small things as well. See, sometimes we go to God when the big things happen. You know, when there's a death, or we go to God when we need money, or when we want a blessing, or we want a breakthrough, or we want to break some curses. We go to God for those big things, but then we forget to go to God for the small things, right? Because we use our crutch for the small things. Well, I work and I get paid, so next payday, I'm just going to wait to get this, because I know when I get that check, I can get what I need to get. When we should be going to God and saying, God, I don't have to wait till payday, because if you're going to be a provider and you're going to give me everything I need, you're going to give it to me before payday even comes, right? And so what is your crutch on this morning? You know, I use my phone so much, I said this before, that I just kept looking for it. I kept looking for the phone. Every 5 minutes, you know, when I'm in my car, my phone just sits on my lap. It just sits on my lap. And so I can just look down real quick and I can see my phone. So I found myself keeping continuously looking down at my phone, you know, and there was nothing there. There was nothing there. And so how often do we look at our phone in Jesus, our Bible? How often do we pick up our Bible and look at our Bibles? How often do we look in our Bibles for direction? That we look in our Bibles for a word? That we look in our Bibles for answers? That we look on our Bibles to call upon somebody? How often do we pick up our Bibles and look at our Bibles? And I'm not just talking about the once a week on Sundays at church. You know, we should be reading our Bibles daily. We should be reading daily. We should be praying daily. We should be doing these things daily, all throughout the day. The Bible says that we should be meditating on his word day and night. If I can meditate on my phone day and night, my phone is right here all the time, why can't I do the same thing for the word of God? Why am I putting my phone before the word of God? Why am I putting my phone before God? Why am I trusting in my phone more than I'm trusting and depending on God? And we all have a crutch. We all have that crutch. You know, sometimes we put our all into our spouse. You know, we know our spouse is going to do everything. They're going to fix everything. They're going to do everything. Our kids put their all into their parents, into us. They know that we're their crutch. We do everything for them. And I know sometimes my husband say, you know, you do too much for those kids, or you just kids crutch because they know they can call you, mama, I need $5. Mama, I need this. Mama, I need that. And so I'm their crutch. But we got to even teach our children that, baby, I can't be your crutch. God has to be your crutch. When you're in trouble, when you need something, you need to go to God, and God will give you what you need. Amen. And so I go into 2 Chronicles. Going into 2 Chronicles chapter 15 and 16, and you can go back and you can read, read chapters 14, 15, and 16 when you have time today. And so it's talking about King Aja. King Aja. And King Aja, he was a king. He ruled for, you know, many years, over 40 something years. He ruled and he was able to fight the Ethiopians and battle the Ethiopians, and he was able to win that battle because he had God. He was able to win that battle because he had God. And so in 2 Corinthians 15 in the second chapter, it says that when the Lord will stay with you as long as you stay with him. Whenever you seek him, you will find him. But if you abandon him, he will abandon you. And so I like that because it says the Lord is going to stay with me when I need him. Whenever I seek him, I'm going to find him. But if I'm not seeking the Lord, how can I find him? My God, Jesus, how can I find the Lord if I'm not seeking him? If I'm not making him number one, if I'm using everything else in my life as a crutch, how am I going to find him? My God. And then down in verse 4, it says, but whenever they were in trouble and turned to the Lord, the God of Israel, and sought him out, they found him. So whenever you sought out for the Lord, whenever you seek the Lord, you will find him. And that's the thing that we have to do on today. We have to seek him out. We have to be sought after the Lord. That means we have to be a daily thing. This is a daily thing. This is a daily thing. It's just not a, oh, every now and then type thing. And you know, I think about it, and women, I hear women all the time, or people all the time, and you know, I'm just going through this and I'm going through that. And I be wanting to say so bad, when was the last time you prayed? Oh, I prayed last night or the night before. But how about praying continuously until you get that answer? How about not just fasting for one day, or fasting for 2 days, or fasting for 3 days? How about you fast until you see a change come? And I'm not saying you have to do an absolute fast where you're not eating anything, but fasting maybe from something, or maybe doing an intermittent fasting until you see that change come. See, we want to maybe just put God into a 3-day fast, or we want to put God into a, well, I'm going to pray about this for every night for the next 3 or 4 nights, and then we just let it go. We stop doing it. But how about you doing this thing continually until you see that change come? I had my son was in a little bit of trouble some months ago, and I said the day he got into the trouble, I said, I'm finna fast right now until we get answers, until something happens. And initially the fast was only 21 days. So I fasted for 21 days. And then on the 21st day, we didn't get the answer that we needed. So I said, God, I'm going to continue fasting until I get my answer. And it ended up being 40 whole days that I fasted, but that was a God thing. God was doing some things in me, but I just didn't stop and fast for 2 days and thinking I'm going to get the answer, or God was going to change things right then and there. I did it until I saw the change. And how many of you today, you're going through some issues, you're having some problems, there's some things that need to change in your life. How many of you are really seeking God, really seeking him? Not just seeking him when you want to seek him, or seeking him when you're down and depressed, but how many of you are really seeking God on a daily basis for that thing? For that theme. And so in verse 7, King Aja, he said, but as for you, be strong and courageous, for your work will be rewarded. So they were telling King Aja, you got to be strong and you got to be courageous, because your work is going to be rewarded. And that's the thing about it, is God is going to reward us for our work down here on earth. God is going to reward us for the things that we're doing. And even if we don't see the reward down here, my God, thank you, Jesus. Even if we don't see the reward down here, we're going to see the reward on the other side, my God. So that's what we should be looking to and focusing on. And so it was coming up that King Aja was getting ready to go into another battle. And so this time he decided that he was going to just rely on himself and on the people around him. And so King Aja, he said, then Aja called together the people of Judah and Benjamin, along with the people of Ephraim, Manasseh, and Simeon. I'm on verse 9, 2 Chronicles 15 and 9. And it says, for many from Israel had moved to Judah during Aja's reign, when they saw that the Lord his God was with him. And I just want to tell you this morning that people will follow you when they see God is with you. People will follow you when they see that God is with you. And so as you're praying, as you're fasting, as you're studying his word, you're going to look different. And people are going to start coming to you. They're going to start flocking to you because they see something different in you. They see that you're depending on God and you're not relying on anything else. And so people will automatically flock to you. People will automatically come to you. See, those resources that you need, that you're looking for, those resources will come to you. God will send them to you because you're doing the right thing. You don't have to go to them. See, in the mornings I do affirmations and I say money is attracted to me. I don't say that I'm attracted to money. I say that money is attracted to me because I know if I stay in the word of God, if I seek God and I put him first, all those things are going to be added to me. That means they're going to come to me. So I don't know what you're looking for this morning or what you're putting your crutch on this morning, but those things, if you're following God, is going to come to you automatically. You don't have to worry about it. And so there was three things that I learned from King Ajah. And again, you guys go back and read it for yourself. But there's three things I learned from him. And I learned that the Lord is going to stay with you as long as you stay with him. And we already talked about that. I also learned that it's easy for people to follow you when they see God in you. And we just talked about that. And the third thing that I learned, that putting your trust in people will allow you to miss your chance. And see, King Ajah kept putting his trust in the people. He kept putting his trust in the people, and he was doing things his own way. See, the first time he went out for the battle, he was able to win the battle because he trusted in God. But see, the second time, he put his trust in himself, and he wasn't able to win. And what I found interesting even about this in the story is one verse that was pointed out to me. And this verse said that King Ajah even deposed his grandmother, Micah, from her position as queen mother because she had made an obscene pole. He cut down her obscene pole, broke it up, and he burned it. But he even disposed of his grandmother. And there's some people that do come to us, even family, that we have to dispose of. They're not good for us. They don't want to be on. They're not pouring into us. They're just continuously taking away from us. They're not following us correctly. And so he had to cut off his grandmother. My God, he had to cut his grandmother off. And so I was real interested in that. I said, "Wow, he cut his grandmama off." So that's deep right there. But again, King Ajah, he started to put his trust, his faith, his hope in people. And that's what I don't want you to do this morning. I want you to really think about that crutch and what you put in your trust, your faith, and your hope into this morning. Is it that thing that you're leaning on, or is it God? And it says, at that time, and because he put his trust in people, it says, and at that time, Hananiah the seer came to King Ajah and told him, "Because you have put your trust in the king of Aram instead of the Lord your God, you missed your chance to destroy the army of King Aram." And so this morning, I just want to tell each and every one of you as daughters of Christ, don't miss your chance because you've put your trust in the wrong thing. Don't miss your chance because you put your trust in your cell phone to get you everywhere you need to go, to get you everything that you need, to get you connected to the people that you need to be connected to. Don't put your trust in this phone. Don't put your trust in man. Don't put your trust in your spouse, your children, your job, your business. Don't put your trust in those things, because if you do, you will miss your chance. You will miss your chance. And the funny thing is that the Lord had even gave King Ajah another chance. He gave him one more chance. And it says in the 39th year of his reign, Ajah developed a serious foot disease. Yet even with the severity of his disease, he did not seek the Lord's help, but turned only to his own physicians. My God, how many of you are sick today? How many of you know people that are sick? I know I got some sick people in my family today. Are we looking at the physicians, or are we looking at God, who is the healer? Who are we looking at today? And so he even missed his chance again. He knew God, but he missed his chance again, even in his disease. And he looked to his physicians to heal him instead of leaning and depending on God to heal him of this foot disease. And so it says that he died in the 41st year of his rain. So my God, so even on today, we need to make sure, even in our healings, in our family healings, that we look to God and not to the physicians. Yes, God gave us doctors. I'm not saying don't go to no doctor. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying that we can't put our trust and dependence on the doctors. The God has the final say for everything. He has the final say. And so on this morning, ladies, I don't want you to miss your chance. Don't miss your chance by depending and leaning on that crutch, but depend and lean on God. My God, thank you so much for listening on today. We're going to go ahead and we're going to go into prayer. My God. And I just want you to really think about it. If you're not fully depending on God this morning, if you're not fully dependent on Him, pray and ask God. First of all, repent. Repent, first of all. And repent to God and tell God that you're sorry. God, I'm sorry for not trusting you. I'm sorry for not giving it all to you. I'm sorry for not surrendering this situation or just surrendering myself to you. Repent to God. Repent to God. And He will forgive you of your sins. And then get back on that right track of depending and leaning on God. Amen. Amen. Dear most gracious Father, God, we just thank you, God. We thank you for another chance, God. We thank you for another day. Lord God, we just thank you for being, who you are, God. Even though, God, there's times that we don't look to you and we don't depend on you, God, we know that you're still there, that you will never leave us, God, and you will never forsake us, God. My God, Jesus, that you will never forsake us, Lord God. Lord, we just ask right now that we give ourselves to you, Lord God, that we lean and depend on you, God, that we don't put our trust in man, Lord, but we depend and lean on you, God. You said in your word that we should look to the hills for what cometh our help from. Our help comes from you, Lord God. And so we're asking right now for you to come in and give us that help, oh God. But we're asking right now for whatever the situations that's before you, that these ladies are putting before you, God, I ask that you just come on down, God, and give them answers, oh God. Fight their battles, oh God. Heal their land, oh God. Heal their family members, oh God. Heal them, oh God. Whatever it is that they're putting before you, oh God. Lord, we're asking that we put the small things as well as the big things before you, Lord God. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we praise you, God. We thank you in advance that we count it done right now in Jesus' name, Lord God. And I know there's a couple of people, Tammy, Lord God, we ask that you touch Tammy's husband on today, Lord God. Lord, I have a brother-in-law who's sick right now, God. I ask that you go in his room and touch him, oh God. We know that you put physicians down here, God, but we know that you are the ultimate healer, Jehovah, Lord God. Lord, so we thank you in advance for their healing, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord. We ask that you go with us throughout today, Lord God. Be with each and every intercessor that's coming on behind me this week, Lord God. Allow them to give a word to your women, oh God, a word of encouragement, a word of motivation, even a word of conviction, Lord God, on today. Lord, we just love you, God. We praise you, and we give you all the honor, the glory, and the praise that is due unto your name. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, and amen. So I want to thank each and every one of you guys for getting on today. I just thank you so much that you decided to just give God your first fruits of the morning. I know we went over just a little bit because we were having a little technical difficulty. Pray for my son in Camp Great Lakes, Illinois. God, we ask that you just touch right now Vicky's son, God. We ask that you just be with him as he's in camp on today, Lord God. Lord, give him the skills, the strength to endure through the training, Lord God. And we count it done. In Jesus' name, Vicky is done in Jesus' name, and he's going to do well. He's going to pass with flying colors in Jesus' name. And so I thank each and every one of you. Go out on today. Be great. Do something in Jesus' name. And we'll see you guys back on here tomorrow morning at 5:30 on the Reignited Prayer Call. God bless.